Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a video on how to kind of get through a bad day. A couple weeks ago I was really struggling, not really feeling like myself. I have figured out a few things that I have started implementing into my daily routine to kind of help me get over those bad days, because you know, bad days happen to everyone. That is just reality. You're not gonna have a perfect day every single day. Every day is not gonna be all rainbows and sunshine, you know? So I think it's important to figure out a few things that work for you that will help you get over those tough days. And I know especially now, you know, some people are still stuck in their houses, not being able to be around a lot of people, and I think that was part of what I was dealing with, because yes, I could go and do things, but I needed to be home for school and I didn't necessarily have the ability to go out and do things. So I was feeling really down and unhappy. I have figured out some things that help me get over and get out of that little slump. So one of the things that I've been doing, and this has been probably the most helpful for me, and that is journaling. If you have seen my other videos, I've literally talked about this in a ton of other videos. I even made a video on how I journal. I will link that down below if you guys want to check it out. I love journaling. It has really helped me so much. Like, even if I'm having a good day, I still like to journal. It's something that I enjoy doing now, and it's amazing. I haven't journaled yet today, so I'm gonna do a little bit of journaling. Basically, so I just write the date at the top, write a few positive things about myself. I wrote a few positive things about myself, and then basically you just can write a reflection. I finished writing my little entry. It's not too long because it's kind of early in the morning, but if I have more thoughts and stuff, I will definitely write them down later. But I totally recommend journaling. Even if you're not in a sad mood, you can journal when you're happy and it makes you feel even better. It's really good just to get your feelings and emotions out. My next tip for you would be to listen to some music. You can go on your Spotify or Apple Play. I have Spotify here on my laptop. You can listen to a podcast, you can listen to music, like a relaxing music to kind of just get your mind off of things that are making you feel not so great. So yeah, definitely help listening to music or listening to podcasts. Some of my favorite podcasts are BAYTS or Bates, which is by Karen and Kwa, and they just like talk about YouTube and stuff like that. I also like Behind the Scenes by Audrey and Jeremy Roloff. You can also find relaxing just music playlists. I have a Good Vibes playlist that I like, relaxing music. You can literally type anything into Spotify and, you know, find really nice music. Or if you don't have Spotify or Apple Play, like literally YouTube, type in relaxing music on YouTube or something, and that can definitely help you. My next tip is to just simply take a nap. Sometimes we just need to take a nap to feel a little bit better and just let our mind rest, relax, and rejuvenate. So having a bad day, try taking a nap. It could be super helpful. You can always read a book. Find a comfy spot, maybe on the floor, on your bed, outside, and just relax and read. Some of my favorite books are The Fault in Our Stars, Creative Love, A Love Letter Life, or The Handy Dandy Bible is also a great one. Or you could pick your favorite, but definitely reading is awesome. It can get your mind off of whatever is making you have a bad day, and you can just get lost in a really great book. You could also do some yoga. Or you could do a workout, do some jumping jacks. Working out and yoga are also super helpful tips for feeling better. It gets you moving, it gets your blood pumping, it gets your endorphins going in your body, and it will make you feel so much better. Whenever I feel like I'm in a slump or tired, I get a nice little workout in and I feel so much better afterwards. So workout. If you don't feel like you could do a super intense workout, yoga is super helpful as well. Another thing that you can do is take a really nice, hot, relaxing bath. I love doing this. so much. It's so relaxing, you know, get that nice warm water, get those Epsom salts in there, some bubble bath, put a few candles on, turn the lights down, listen to relaxing music, read a book in the bath, read a magazine, watch some YouTube videos, anything. A bath is so awesome. Just let the stress of the day just drift away and you will feel so much better. Baths really, really help me. Doing anything self-care, do a hair mask, do a face mask, paint your nails, go get a manicure, go get a pedicure, like treat yourself. You totally deserve it. So anything spa related, do it, because you will just, it'll make you feel better. Something else you can do is just get outside and be in nature, go for a walk, go look at some pretty flowers. I'm gonna see if I can find some over in this garden over here on my lawn so I can show you guys. I see a few, but especially since the weather's getting warmer out now, being outside, just being in nature, I know definitely when I'm not feeling the best, when I go for a nice walk, it's super awesome and relaxing. Here's some pretty flowers that I found that I'll show you guys. Maybe this will brighten your day if you're currently having a bad day. Look at how pretty. So cute. Get outside, get some fresh air. That's totally good for like your overall health. Another tip that I have for you is to go and get your favorite drink, whether it's iced coffee or smoothie or anything. You can go get it, you can make it at home, like treat yourself. You deserve it because you've been working hard. But definitely go get your favorite drink. Whenever I love going to Dunkin' to get iced coffee, that always makes me feel so much better. It's so crazy how like literally just like having a drink can help make you feel really good. And yeah, so go get your favorite drink, make your favorite drink at home, make something that you enjoy making. My last and final tip for you guys is just to do what you love and to do what makes you happy. If that's doing a sport or going hang out with your friends or watching your favorite Netflix show, anything, just do what makes you happy, because you know yourself the best and you know what really is gonna fix your bad day. So just go do what you love and take a few hours just for yourself to recuperate from whatever is happening in your life. Okay guys, those are all the tips that I have for you. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I hope that some of these tips were helpful for you and that they can help you get out of your bad day. And if you're watching this and you're having a bad day right now, just know that it's just one day. Tomorrow is a whole new day and you can make it however you want it to be. Wake up tomorrow and say, I am going to have a good day, and make it a good day. If you're in a bad mood when you wake up, go journal, go work out, do something to keep your mind off of whatever may be bothering you, and just know that it's going to get better and that each day will pass, and just take it one thing at a time and you can get through this and you got this. I love you guys so much. I will see you guys in my next video, and